Hey guys, Andrew here, also known as SlayerRock86. Today I will be installing a clear DVD drive for your Xbox 360 from ExtremeMods.com. Now, if you use the promo code FireRockerStudios, you get 5% off. Now, I already opened up my Xbox 360. If you guys do not know how to open up an Xbox 360, just go on an annotation somewhere in this video or the link below. I made a video previously showing you guys how to open up the Xbox 360 so you don't have any questions. So, here's the drive, and it's got little holes right here. It comes with this, which apparently is sticky in the bottom, and you take out the extra edges and you put it on, so it's a pretty much a clear cover. And you will be able to hear this spinning inside. So first, you gotta take the DVD box out. Now, I don't know how good you guys can see this, but there are two cables inside. I will pop them off real quick and then show you guys. And it's very easy, you just snap them right off. Here they are. Here's the box, and let me show you the Xbox 360. They are right there, and right there. And you just pull them off, very simple, very easy, and very safe. Okay, so right here is the DVD box. You are going to need, I guess, a regular screwdriver. You probably won't have one at home, unless if you're weird and you don't. So to unscrew it, I'm gonna fast forward through this because I don't really want to show you this. But you basically just unscrew that one, that one, that one, that one, that one, and that one. So I guess it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws. So let me fast forward through the unscrewing. Okay guys, so I unscrewed all of them. As you can see, they are all out. Now, you simply just have to pull off, I am guessing. And let me try to get this released in part. I think, yeah, there we go. I think that's the bottom. I'm not 100% sure. And yeah, look, by the looks of it, it's the bottom. So let me put that back and try to flip this over. Trying to take the top. The top is kind of hard for me to take out, showing you the video at the same time. I guess just grip the little legs. I'm doing this live, by the way, guys. So that's kind of why it's kind of weird. So just give it a good grip and pull it upwards. And I think I've got it. And it's kind of weird. Again, when you guys do it, it's going to be easier. Right now, I have to do it in an angle so I can show you. And there you go. Here is the drive. Now, let me put this boring old cover away because this is not necessary. And let me grab the new one. And I guess this is the only thing that was in the old one. Just kind of a weird spinny thing. And with the new one, you just have this. So yeah, pretty sweet. And honestly, I don't think you do anything with this. Oh, there we go. Okay, let me move that apart a bit. And let me connect or put this together real quick. So I guess I kind of took the legs off when I installed it. So just putting this back so you guys can see it. And let me move it over here. There we go. So this is the DVD box. Let me put that flat down. And it just popped off. Okay, so to install this, I'm guessing you simply, here we go, it's got a cover to it. Let's peel that off, grab this, and peel that off, and I think, there we go, you gotta be kind of careful, this is glue, and my camera's about to run out of battery, so you just simply install this right on your drive box. Here, let me move that a bit. If you mess up, don't worry, you can keep putting it back on. I'm just gonna try to get this perfect the first time, so give me a second, guys. And yep, I got it. There you go, guys. That's how you put it on. Now, real quick, my camera's about to die, so let me skip to the part when I'm putting it in. Okay guys, so here I have it all in. I have my cover from ExtremeMods.com, just saying that again. And you simply just have to put this side frontwards. Let me try to get a good shot so you guys can see. Very simple to do. Let me zoom in a little. And yeah, just push it in like that. Now, the cool thing about this, as you can see, it is a clear cover. You will be seeing your disc spinning inside. and I will show you that later on once I have my Xbox 360 all custom painted. Not custom painted, customized and turned on so I can put a DVD drive in there. And of course, I will be taking this off and replacing it with a black one. But yeah, so now the rest of the process is very simple. You simply got to screw these 6 screws back in, and I'm not gonna waste your time so you guys can see that. I'm just gonna fast forward, so here's the skip. And I got the screws on, guys. So here's pretty much the box with everything on it. So you could see DVD drive here, all screwed in. Now I am going to install it on. Now again, you just look at these little holes right there, that one. Just one over there, one there, and right in between here is where you'll be installing it. So real quick, I'm actually gonna take this out and switch it with a clear one, but I'm gonna show you how you can install this first. So you will just put, well first, you're going to, like I said, these cables, you're gonna reconnect them. You're gonna put the white one goes, actually yeah, the white one goes with the light one, which kinda looks white and brownish, and then the black one just goes onto the little black one. Once you have that done, you just put it flat down, make sure that you've got the holes all right and aligned, and there we go. We just installed a really cool clear cover. So if you guys have a clear case, or like me, you have one with a window. Let me see if I got this right. There we go. Once it's all covered, you will be able to see your disc spinning inside. And if you have LEDs, it's gonna look even cooler, guys. Thank you for watching, and make sure to check out the rest of the project when we put everything together, when we put some fans here. It's gonna be really cool, so make sure to check that video out. Annotations all around, and in the link below, in the drop bar.